What's up, everybody? My name is Braskus, and welcome back to Mutant Year Zero Road to Eden. So, couple of things. We have upgraded our weapons to level 2 in most cases. I think we did that at the end of the last episode. We bought the ability that makes it so these now heal for 6 instead of for 3. And I did buy this ability for Bormann, though I'm not using it right now. It's handy, but I really like him being able to restore his health by eating corpses of his downed enemies. I thought about spending 5 points to get Twitch Shot, but I figured if I'd spend the 6 on this one, it unlocks them, and if I'm patient, then I can get Spore Cloud to emit smoke, making it really hard for them to hit him more than once. Or this, which gives him increased accuracy on a weapon like his Boomstick. So, just to kind of give me better options in the future for what I want to spend my points on, I figured I would buy that one for him. Pharaoh still has 4 points, but I'm not spending them because it just gives her this ability, which I don't care about so much. I would rather her save up and either buy the Moth Wings, increased chance of crit by 10%, or potentially take the Gunslinger one instead. So, kind of undecided, but right now she still has the disabled mechanical enemy for 1 turn, which could be really handy. So, here we are. We're in the Iza and Fala location, which was full of ghouls that way and metal men this way. But if we engage them far enough away, we might be able to pull this off. So here's my idea, and I have no idea if this is going to work, but we're going to try it. We're going to get in close to this Polis bot, and we're going to ambush him. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to have Dux and Bormann fire their silenced weapons, and I'm going to have Pharaoh disable it for a turn, which I'm hoping means that the other bot won't notice right away. And then I can try and continue attacking him the following round, maybe kill him with silenced weapons. I don't think I have enough damage to do that. But then I can open fire with the big weapons, and I only have to engage one of them instead of both of them. So that's the current plan. So we're going to make a quick save here since we're right here. And then we're going to do this. Alright, so Dux, crossbow, Polis bot. 4 damage. Now, Bormann, not Boomstick. Ancient pistol. Wait, this is Bormann I'm on, right? Yeah. I gave Bormann the ancient pistol? I thought I gave Pharaoh the ancient pistol. What did I give Pharaoh? This might be a problem. Oh, shoot. No, I didn't change. Damn it. I was on Pharaoh. Crap. I forgot I gave her the same ability that he had. I looked at Corpse Eater and I didn't pay attention to what I was. Okay. Yeah, okay, hold on. We're gonna reload that. Now that I wasn't paying attention. If it's me being stupid, I'm gonna reload it. I'm trying not to just reload every time something goes wrong, because I could save scum my way through this whole game, but I'm just kinda like, I haven't really finished. That wasn't what I intended to do. Combat hasn't started in earnest. I'm gonna give myself a gimme on that one, and we're gonna do it again the right way. Okay, so Dux, crossbow, shoot him.
Yeah, I did that.
I was right though. I did give Pharaoh the silenced pistol. Okay, so not Pharaoh, Bormann, who has the needle pistol. I knew that. I don't know why I didn't think of it. Shoot him. Now Pharaoh, you are instead going to use this ability and disable the Polis. Oh God. -25%. Hit chance, so maybe I need to get her in closer then, if she can't do it from that distance. Alright, bit of a risk, but we're doing it. Just move in here. And now, there we go, with a 75% chance.
Say my name, she's white.
Oh shoot.
It's Pharaoh.
Okay, well, the enemy heard me. It still worked out. Not quite the way I'd have envisioned, but it still worked out. Uh-oh.
You have the right to remain silent.
Ow. Okay. Alright, not quite what I was anticipating. Can you eat metal dudes? No, metal guys don't leave a corpse. Okay, well, that tells me something I wanted to know. He's out of range. That's problematic. Okay. Alright, well, I haven't given up on run and gun yet, so why don't you go ahead and use it? Because I think I need you to get in close. I also don't see any easy way up on top of that thing, so whatever we do, we're just going to have to go for this. 75% chance from there, 75% chance. I'm just going to rely on this. I'm going to rely on them being able to do enough damage for this to work. Not the Mimir pistol, the boomstick. Which certainly did a lot of damage. Now, you're going to change. And then, what kind of a crit chance do we have? Jeez, only 25% chance even to hit from here. Oops, sorry. All right, I think I'm going to try and maybe let him Mothwings himself up. Okay, that'll give him way better height. It'll also give him a much better crit chance. 90% crit chance. Man, that is gorgeous. When Dux has the height, he can do amazing things. And Pharaoh is, like I said, out of range. I knew that. Okay, well, again, I'm going to kind of rely on a level up helping us out here. So I'm going to just sort of let them keep getting in close here and doing the damage. If she has to take another shot from the shotgun, then so be it. He won't survive another round of combat with us. And I think we're far enough away that the ghouls are not going to get drawn into the combat. Oh, and he seems to be stunned. So I think we have a chance to just take him down. Except if that kind of crap happens. Come on.
I am the beautiful weapon.
Okay. All right. So that eliminated all of that. There's no way up on top of that, so for just a moment here, we're going to switch zone characters. I thought Selma had the way to do this. Oh, I can just loot it from here. Okay, never mind. That was completely unnecessary. Go back to Pharaoh. For the time being, I'm gonna keep using Pharaoh. And I saw more stuff over here. Broken gun, okay. Common scrap. Did I seriously just miss all this coming through here the first time? Thought I checked this place out pretty thoroughly, but here I am just trolling past all kinds of stuff. Okay, now they were all concerned about the machines I just destroyed. So now it should just be them. Another broken gun. That one I understand why I didn't have. He was standing right next to it. Okay, I remember going through here and coming close to them, but they weren't wandering into the building, so that was all fine. I don't see anything out here. Okay, I think we're good. So now I just need to start trying to find some stealthy, safe-ish places to pick off some of the ghouls. And reminding myself who exactly was out here. There was a tank, I believe. There's a shaman. Okay, so I see a shaman and a hunter. I would really like to eliminate the shaman first. Also another marauder and a hunter up there. So I only see four, and they've all only got 12 HP. Which, to be honest, is actually not that bad. I'm not that afraid of 12 hit points anymore. Between all the damage they can do, 12 hit points is something that I can end pretty fast. Now, silenced I don't think is going to make a whole lot of difference here, because they're all too close. and I'm not going to be able to kill two of them without alerting other people. So, I think I'm just going to try and pick the best spots I can. Oh, there is a tank over there too, okay. Shaman moved inside, didn't they? Where'd the shaman go? I really want the shaman gone first. I can focus on the tank later. But the shaman is somebody I do not want to deal with later. I want them gone, and I want them gone now. So, ducks, you hide there. How close can Borman... Oh, shoot.
Get over here.
Wait, where are...
It's dangerous. Take him.
Are they down... They're up above. How did they notice me? Oh, there's a hole in the ceiling I didn't see. Crap. Alright, well, I didn't have time to save, so we're gonna just go for this. This is what I have to prepare for now. I screwed up, so this is my fault, and I'm gonna stick to it. Oh, no. Eh, it wasn't too bad. Okay, I have grenades. I think I might need to use them on some of the guys that were behind me. Those grenades will do a lot of damage. Man, they're everywhere now. I was not anticipating this level of resistance. But again, totally my fault. Okay, where were the hunters? Were they all the way up there? I lost track of where they all went. There's the four guys that are up here in front of me. I don't see the other three, though. Maybe I should just focus on these guys in front of me first. Alright, what do we got in the way of damage? I have a hand grenade. I could use that to hit the three of them for a bunch of damage. I'm gonna do it. Could I hit all of them, though? Where's that Marauder at? Is he up above me still? I think he must be. Alright, we'll hit the three of them. It also obliterates all their cover, which is fantastic. Okay, activate ducks. Yeah, the Marauder's up top. Tank's over there. Shaman. Okay, screw it. Going in hot. Nah, I'm gonna let somebody else take care of him. I'm gonna use ducks to finish off one of the hunters. Okay. Let's go for that one over there. Or maybe, I don't know. Try for this guy. Ugh, sad. Okay, well then in that case, God, I need to increase something. I need to get a mod to increase Pharaoh's range, because her range is kind of terrible. Yeah, those are not going to help me at all. And I guess I could switch to this. Damage is only 5 points, but it's better aim. Let's use this for the moment. Now see, Borman I can leave. Why didn't it let me use Borman? I guess he's just going later in the turn order? Oh no, I tossed a grenade with him. Never mind, okay. I'm just crazy. Everything is fine. No, you don't. Thank you for Bardon pointing out in the last episode that the armor I'm wearing with Borman is what prevents him from being charged. So, you just can't charge him. Doesn't do any good.
Get the fox girl.
Okay, they're a way back. Alright, so that's actually really nice. So I don't mind this quite so much. Okay, this is Pharaoh. She's got her shotgun. Go ahead and boomstick the shaman, please.
I'm the hero. You're the zero.
Now, Bormann, this is when I kind of wish he had the ability to... Ugh. Shoot twice. You know, the one I haven't unlocked yet. Focus on the tank or take out the hunter. There's a marauder and the hunter and the tank. Okay, I'm gonna try and focus on some of the other characters first.
Good.
Okay, no ammo in the equipped. Oh, right. Well, I have to reload one way or the other. 100% no line of fire, no line of fire. So, yeah, fire the tank. It's not perfect.
No sweat on it.
Yeah, see, he can eat corpses too, you know, and there is one right down here, so. If Bormann takes some damage, Bormann takes some damage. He's absorbing a lot of it, so I think he'll be okay for now. As for the guys behind me, I could probably overwatch them. Or just start taking shots through the open window. Ducks. No line of fire, no line of fire, no line of fire. 25%. Okay, so I'll probably have to move him. But that way he's at least got a 50% chance. So I'm gonna move him over here. Come on, I know one of them I've got a chance to hit. What do you mean no line of fire? You told me I had line of fire. Fine, going to Overwatch. All right. So, Bormann. Man, there's so many of them at this point, too. How does that move forward? 50%, 50%, 50%. Move over here. I'm gonna do that. It's gonna risk opening my fire to the guy that's further up. But it gives him a better shot at the tank. And we lit him on fire. So, yay us. Don't know what happened to Pharaoh. Oh, I put her into Overwatch. Right, because with... It worked out. But with Ducks, I reloaded and then moved him. I keep losing track of whose turn it is and who's doing what. Makes me feel very foolish. As it probably should. Oh, it's so annoying. He can't shoot around corners. I mean, Ducks should have had an aim at that person, but didn't. Okay, Bormann, I really want to try and drop this guy if we can, so let's just try and focus on the tank. Switch to Pharaoh. I'm gonna move her a little bit. It might trip the Overwatches. It did not. Boomstick him, please.
You don't know who you're messing with. Ask your hurt.
Critical would have been really nice there. Oh, well. All right. I'm gonna let Ducks actually keep focusing on the guys that are out here. Or rather, start focusing on the guys that are out here. Alright, he took another point. The tank will continue to burn. Alright, he took 2 points from that. If I let Pharaoh kill the tank, Bormann can eat him, and then everybody will be fine. Butcher and the Marauder. Who missed? Sweet. Alright, reload. Ducks might get in a little trouble with the butcher that's out there, but I think it's okay. It's worth the risk. Please hit him, though. Thank you.
Yeah, you did it, kid.
All right, so that solves that problem. Pharaoh. Reload. Kill the tank.
Say my name, she's white. It's Pharaoh.
Lovely girl.
For a newbie.
Now, Borman. Go snack on his remains, please. Nom 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 nom. And then you should reload as well. And Pharaoh can do all that same stuff in terms of healing. The only person who needs medkits now, really, if I keep a steady supply of corpses, is Ducks. Yeah, they're gonna smack him around a bit. Ow! They hit pretty hard. Alright, but there's only the two of them. There's the guy upstairs still, which is a little annoying. 75% chance. Yeah, hit him. And then I want Pharaoh to try and finish this guy off.
Man, I'll go easy on ya.
Hated that asshole.
And now Ducks can reload and take his shot at this guy.
That had to hurt.
Kind of wish I'd been able to put him on higher ground, but I made a mistake pretty early in. Okay, so we got one guy outside, one guy on the roof, and one guy out the door. And none of them are being overly effectual, so adios.
Now that was a good kill.
Now, I don't know if Pharaoh can get a decent shot at this guy from anywhere. He's kind of... he's in a pretty weird place. I don't think I'm gonna be able to shoot at him. Now, basically, I have no line of fire anywhere to him. Though he can keep shooting at her, which is a little annoying. Alright, in that case, can you sprint? You can, but not really to anywhere good for you. So maybe what I'll do is I'll move her to the base of the stairs. And I'll put her into Overwatch. So if he tries to shoot her from up on top of the stairs, we can take him out. Then you are going to run and gun. So you can sprint over here and waste this dickhead. Bye.
Yeah, baby.
Only one guy left. And yeah, I kind of thought he might do that, so I'm not particularly upset. Pharaoh? Wait, really? You have to sprint to get to the top of the stairs? That's actually really annoying. Okay, we'll run over here then. I guess move out over here. Try switching weapons. And shoot at him. There we go.
And stay down. Good night, rotheads.
Iridia has new items for sale in the Ark Shop. Really now?
Hey, over here.
All right. Now we can run around and collect all the goodies that got dropped. That part's always exciting. I think there was a ladder up here, wasn't there? Yeah, it's over on this side. That's how I should have gotten up there. Okay. Something over here, really? I got it. scrap. Oh, right, and the big shiny box. What do you got? Pipe gun. That's actually one of the items that was for sale and ready to shop. And now it's mine. Still feel like there should be something here. Kind of looks like there is, but I think it's maybe just a smoke particle effect or something. I don't think there's actually anything there. Okay. I believe that was everything. The shaman we killed, we got the stuff. Dead guy up top, but he's gone. Yeah, I think that's everybody. So this area is, should be pretty well cleaned out. Okay. So maybe what we'll do now is head back to Ark, see what new items Iridia has available for sale. Oh, right, I should actually check this, though. Dux has 4 points available. Well, if he spends 4 to disable an organic enemy's movement for 2 turns, or disable a mechanical enemy for 1 turn, if he saves to 6, become invisible until you attack would be nice, but I like his sniper bonuses. 8 increased movement, so I think I'm going to save Dux's points. She's got 7. So, for her, I'm a little torn. Mothings would be kind of cool, but it's not really that critical for her. This one permanently increases chance of crit damage by 10%, which would be really nice. Increases health by 1 HP. And this one would, of course, shoot multiple targets using 1 AP. And she doesn't... Oh, but she'd have to give up disable mechanical enemies. Still, if I use it at the right time, it'd be nice to have to switch out. Tough call. I think I'm gonna actually save up for 1 more level and try and get her the permanent chance of a crit increase. Okay. So, let's go back to Ark. Because at this point, we've done the Iza and Fala thing. And I don't think there's anything left to find. See what Iridia has. Oh, and what the Elder probably has to say. It's the first time I've ever come back here and he hasn't had something to say.
Welcome back to Iridia's.
Grenades. Be nice to buy 1 more of those to replace the one I used. 20% of weapon range. I feel like I should probably get that for her shotgun for Pharaoh's. 30% to weapon range. Really expensive, though. 15% crit chance. Well, maybe I should save the scrap. It'll take a little longer, but for 200, 30% weapon range addition for a shotgun is pretty sweet. I'm gonna buy 1 of these, though.
Buy now.
Who needed it? You needed it. Oh, wow, I have a lot of grenades. I forgot that I replaced a few, I guess. You have a Molotov, and then you should actually take a grenade instead of a... Okay, I feel a lot better about that now. And weapons, I have the pipe gun now. But I don't really think I care that much about the pipe gun, to be honest. Okay. Let me visit Delta's Fix Pit. I don't think I have any more mods available,
Welcome
but
to the Fix Pit.
Figure I should check. This is Pharaoh's. Yeah, no scopes available. All right. Is anybody in my main series, do they have a level 1 gun left? Boomsticks, level 2. Level 2. Level 2, level 2, level 2, and level 2. So, no. Magnus's Rambino is level 1, but hers is level 2. So I think at this point, I'm just going to start saving the weapons parts, and I might start upgrading weapons to level 2. Or, sorry, level 3. Okay, I don't have anything else, so let's be on our way. Metal Fields. Now, this is where it's going to get interesting, because there's a lot of guys down here. So I need to try and be careful, and they are all robotic. but if I pick my fights carefully, I should be able to engage one or two of them at a time instead of drawing the entire place down on my head. So that's kind of our goal. And I'm just gonna make a new save since I'm already here in case I do something stupid. Okay, so we found Pharaoh right here. Were there any nasties over this way? I think there were. Yeah, there's at least one over there. There's a polis bot that way. And one out that way, polis bot enforcer out here. And these guys have a lot more health. But the enforcers wound up being really nasty versus the other ones. So, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna come way over here. Would you stop? Jeez. If I'm gonna deal with one of them, I wanna deal with the enforcer first. So this is a good spot to save, again. Now we'll wait till the polis bot walks back the other way. Once he's walked back far enough, we'll tangle with this guy here. I don't know if silenced weapons... I'm positive silenced weapons aren't gonna do enough to kill this guy. So we're just gonna kinda go big or go home on this one.
Now it's getting fun.
Okay, the other guy did hear us, but we got a crit. And the idea is to try and eliminate the polis bot enforcer first. And deal with the other guy second. Now, in the interest of trying to eliminate one before the other, I'm gonna take him out of combat for a bit. Now, the other guy should come in here. Enemy's turn, here comes the polis bot. What in the hell? Is that a taser? That's not cool. All right, well.
I am the beautiful weapon. Come get some.
Unfortunately, I still need this guy gone first, and he doesn't seem to be taking damage. He's just out of the fight for a bit. No, I'm not even gonna risk it. I want him gone. Move into where you've got 100% chance and eliminate him. Okay, the enforcer's out. And this guy seems to be the only one left. Oh, crap. Okay. I was not anticipating that. Okay, life just got a lot more complicated. We're gonna try for it, but yeah, life just got a lot more complicated. God, would it even be worth it to try and hide? I don't even know that I could. Oh, God, that is a shit chance to hit. Sorry. I've got this, though. I can get up really high with a very high crit chance, so we're gonna do that. Fifty percent, 75%, it's just these two. Yeah. There we go. Damaged and crit. Now Pharaoh, can you really do much from here? Probably not. But get in close as you can while still being able to shoot at him and do so. Okay, now he seems to be stunned a little bit, which is fantastic. Do I want to use a run and gun to finish him off? I think I do. Oh, no, no, that's not run and gun. That's run and gun. All right. Oh, here we go. Okay. That's those two down. This is still gonna scare the crap out of me, but... Oh, I can't believe I'm doing this. I was not expecting to fight all of them at once. I really was trying to pick them off a couple at a time. Okay, I see, I think I counted four. Two enforcers and two standard polis bots. I do have some EMP grenades, so if stuff starts to get real hairy, I do have a way of dealing with that. And I think Pharaoh might actually have... ...50%, 75... Okay, we're gonna keep going for this.
Does that hurt?
I think Pharaoh might have her ability to lock them in place ready again? Oh no, she needs one more kill to do it. Alright, that's... That's okay, though. We're gonna give it to her before too long here.
Say my name, Jizzwipe. It's Pharaoh.
God, these polis bots are so hard. Although, look at that. It seems like once they suffer enough damage, like maybe after they drop below half, they start to get stunned. They suffer an EMP break or something.
1033, requesting emergency assistance.
Yeah, it kind of sucks that he's gonna take a little more damage or be stunned. He can't help me with these guys. But the two of them should be able to end this dude, so I don't really mind right now. The little polis bots are annoying, but they're not dangerous while they're stunning me. The polis bot enforcers, on the other hand, can be a major problem, so they're the ones I'm concerned about. He just wanted to overwatch. I can stun one of them now, though, because I got the third kill I needed. Did he take damage from that? He did. He took a little bit of damage from that. Unload.
Don't it.
If that's all he's taking, though, is one point of damage, I don't really care.
You're the zero. Ask your hurt.
I'm in this for the damage. If the other polis bot gets too close, though, that's when I might have an issue. Ugh, God. Okay, hang on a minute. I need to deal with these guys first. Bummer. Okay, it's fine. I'm gonna go for this here. Well, wait a minute. Where's Pharaoh able to move? Yeah, Pharaoh can still only make the same moves he can. But her chance is better over here, so she's gonna move to there. And unload on the enforcer. Okay, there is another guy way over there in the back that I didn't see before.
Have been deemed hazardous.
I didn't think I used Borman, did I? Well... If I did, so be it, I guess. Okay, now the polis bot's doing something else. He missed. He was gonna try and do the same thing, so it doesn't last forever. Reload your boomstick. Please clean him off the face of the earth. I mean, I guess it would have taken a little more than that, but that's fine. You reload. Man, I don't really have a great shot at either one of these guys. Okay, but I want you to maybe be under better cover, so you come over here. Make them come to you. And you finish off the enforcer, please.
Give up now, and I'll go easy on ya.
Okay, this is actually going quite smoothly. I was anticipating a much harder fight with this many of them incoming. But this little corner's been kind of nice. There's a lot of cover out here. And because I picked them, picked where I did to fight them, they're not really in a great position to come after me. Okay, I'm gonna give him the run and gun again. And I'm gonna move him over here. He'll have cover against the guy behind him, but not the guy in front of him, and that's just, that's kind of okay with me. Okay, Dux has his moth wings back. So I think I'm gonna use that. Still might not give him the best chance in the world. But that's what we're doing. Nice. Still got him on a 50-50. Which is about as good as I could have asked for. And as long as I draw them out... Uh-oh. Well, he missed anyway. Okay.
You don't know who you're messing with.
And he wasn't undercover anymore, so we're good. Okay, so I think that Polis bot's the only one left.
Comply. Comply. Comply.
Okay, now he did hit Pharaoh. But I still think we can handle it. Alright, it's not really gonna make a whole lot of difference. I don't have a good shot at this guy from anywhere. Ooh, yes I do. I'm over here. And he still missed. All right, well, that's fine. What's my aim from, say, here? Oh, right, I still need to reload. All right, well, reload. Can I even get him from here? No. From here, it's... I can't tell, and it won't tell me because I can't hit him anyway, so just go to there. And we'll let it be their turn. Okay, how about now? Still no chance to hit, huh? What do I have to go to hit him from? Alright, just go to here. Sooner or later, I'll either get the chance to get him. I think maybe he's got too much cover. Just keep moving forward. Okay, you need to reload. And then take the shot. I want to try and interrupt this. Or hell, maybe I don't. If she takes a few shots for the team, then so be it. Hold on, though. Can you move up here? Yeah, just go to where I've got a guaranteed shot instead of wasting shots that I don't have to. Really? 25? Why is my shot chance so pitiful from here? I mean, go for it, I guess, but... Man, he just... I don't know what the deal is. Alright, well, he'll go for Borman. And he got Borman. Okay, reload. I guess just take the shot. I might get lucky, and if I don't, then, I mean, Borman's not going to take that much damage from this. In the meantime, Pharaoh can run over here. She's also got next to no chance, but she can at least take the shot. Eh, she's got 50. Oh, no, she doesn't. Well, go for it anyway. They're low chances, but he's tied up fighting Borman. So I don't really mind it too much. You know what? Switch weapons, and then just come over here.
I'm the hero, you're the zero.
I really hate when they do that. Alright, reload. And this time, just come over here. We'll just pin him in. He can pick whoever he wants to stun, but he's basically surrounded by all of us. He's going down this round.
Fun.
Knocked him over, but he's apparently still stunning him. which still leaves Pharaoh.
Give up now and I'll go easy on ya.
Thank you. He's wasted, we're fully healed, we're also level 33. Okay, that's a little weird. Could you maybe stop being... whatever. Elysium Driver 100, additional crit damage, chance to knock back enemies 100%. Nice.
Come on.
That's one of the more amusing bugs I've seen recently. Okay, tell you what, I'm going to actually wander back towards the entrance. We'll just walk out and walk back in, because it's going to drive me nuts if I have to listen to him crackle and pop through this entire thing. When did I walk past that? Ignore it. No idea. Doesn't matter. Let's see, where... Okay, this is where I came in. Travel. The enemies won't respawn, so it should be fine. Ah, look at that. All the areas that were previously, you know, scary, red, too high level, don't go here, are now considered challenge appropriate. Huh? Okay. And now that everything's fine, go back to the metal fields, then we'll see about leveling up, because we've got the points to spend, and maybe we'll try and finish off the metal fields. Since, so far as I can tell, there's only one guy left, maybe two. Alright, let's take a look here. Dux has 6 points available. I think I want to save the 8 for him, though, because movement is kind of becoming a pain for him. So I'm going to save up 2 more points. Borman's got 5. I'm going to give him this one. Kind of regretted not having it in the last fight, so we're just going to do that. She's got 9 points available, and I wanted her to have the extra crit chance. Okay, cool beans. Let's go. Is anybody not using their flashlight? No, everyone's using their flashlight. Now, I also know... So that's the way that we're supposed to go. Man, I was like right by that entrance, wasn't I? But there's also something else over here. Aside from the one guy that's, you know, over there, I'm pretty sure. We have the key for this area, the quarantine area key, I think is what it was called. And it should get us in over there. Oh, that's right. There might be a few more than I was anticipating originally. There might actually be a couple extras. And there's stuff in here. EMP grenade. That's handy. All right, let's go take a look over this. Okay, so I see one Polis bot enforcer there and one Polis bot, another Polis bot inside. Okay, so that's 3 bots over on this end. And I believe that going inside the tents over here, there was at least one more guy. So, what I'm thinking is I put Dux up top somewhere, if at all possible. And we try to focus on the enforcer first. That'll be my spot, right there ahead of us. We'll hit the enforcer and it'll wake up the other two. But if we can eliminate the enforcer first, or you know, maybe let's see if there's how many are over here. Oh shoot, my god, there's a lot of guys. So we have another Polis bot and another Polis bot enforcer over here on this side, plus the ones over on that side. So I'm counting at least 5 bots that I need to eliminate still. Okay, split up.
Wait here.
climb up. And before I go any further than this, I'm making a new save so that I don't have to redo the metal field stuff I've already done. Now, from here I can see three guys. Not happy about the fact that one of them's an enforcer back there, though. That's actually very distressing to me. But I kind of have a plan in mind, so we're gonna try it. My concern is that with ducks up there, I'm gonna try and deal with these guys starting with that enforcer first. But there's another enforcer. And if Dux is on his own up there, I know the enforcers can travel that high. At least I'm pretty sure. And so if that enforcer jumps up there, then Dux is all by himself with one enforcer, and I don't know that I like him being in that position. But I think we're gonna have to just go for it. Or if I don't like this one, I suppose I could try going to the other side, deal with the Polis bot enforcer. But I just don't want him getting stunned up there either. Okay, I'm already in position. I'm not gonna overthink it too much. We're gonna give it a shot right now. If this goes really poorly, then we may have to call it an episode, but we're gonna give it a shot. Right here, right now. ...75% chance to hit. Does she have 75 from here? No, she's got 50, so it's worth it to me that she moves in. Will alert new unit. Will apparently not alert new unit. Alright, can we go here and do this? We can! That's cool. If I switch to this and then do it... No. No. We're just gonna try and take this guy out. She's got a 90% crit with this shotgun too, so...
Say my name, she's white.
It's Pharaoh! 12 damage! Hard to argue with that. Now, Borman, you activate too. And you wander right over here. I don't care if you fail at sneaking. Unload! And you activate as well. Won't be able to kill him, but I can do a lot of damage. Kind of debating actually critting one of the Polis bots, because the other guy's fried for a turn. He can't do anything. So we're going to actually do this on the Polis bot. See, as long as Dux is shooting down, he can hit everybody down there for pretty much almost 100% chance of crit. Yeah, here comes the Polis bot. See, this is exactly what I was concerned about. This thing right here, 100%, is what my biggest concern was going to be. Alright, well... I guess target the Polis bot down there. Since he's basically my new damage dealer, we're gonna let him do this from down here, and we're gonna let Pharaoh finish off the... Well, might not actually be Pharaoh. It'll probably be Pharaoh and Borman. Dux might just have to take a hit for the team here. It's not ideal at all, but it may just be what he has to do. Okay, they both missed, thank Christ.
Disturbance in area.
Yeah, I know.
You have been deemed hazardous.
Ow. Kinda hurt. Wasn't awful, but it kinda hurt. Okay. I'm gonna try and get them over to high ground to help out Dux. In the meantime, Dux is gonna just keep weathering some hits and eliminating the guys on the ground. Can Pharaoh hit him? 50% out of range. I mean, it's not a great chance to hit, but she could. Otherwise, she sprints way over here. Ooh, can she maybe... That's 25% chance, though. That's the problem. So not really, no. All right, I'm gonna move her over here. We're just gonna kind of have to play this by ear and hope that it goes well. If best case scenario is actually pretty much that. The Polis bot gets down and leaves me the hell alone. Was about what I was gonna say. So that went about as well as I could have hoped. Says she's got 100% chance from here, so wander over here.
I am the beautiful weapon. Come get some.
Nice. And he's been EMP'd, which is even better. He's got enough to run and gun, so why don't we do that? Does he have armor on that? It's low cover, but it's still cover. Okay. Dux took a bit of a hit, but he's back in the running and able to get some pretty decent shots off. Oh, he got Borman. A little annoying. Alright, well, reload. It's still in 25. No line of fire. Focus on the guy that's down here.
Does that hurt?
I should really try to take out these Polis bots. I mean, as much as the Enforcer is bad news, the Polis bots could be worse. She's got 9 damage. She's only got 1 armor. It's not a great chance to hit, though, is the biggest problem I've got. Okay, well, get in here. And take the shot, I think. And I guess I can kind of go either way with it, really.
I'm the hero, you're the zero.
Okay. Polis bot eliminated. We've got the one Enforcer and one other Polis bot, and that's left. That's it. Borman is, however, shocked, which is not fantastic. I'm gonna try and shoot him for a 50 chance here. And I'll move in to really start hitting him next time. Now, he has to reload or he'll never be able to shoot. So you go ahead and do that. And then I need him... Wait, really? You can't... That's annoying. All right, here's what we're gonna do. This is kind of crazy, but we're doing it. Oh, he reloaded, that's right, okay. So if he sprints, he can get over there, which is really annoying. But if I use this, and I go up and above, it still won't be a great chance to hit, but it still lets me move and shoot in the same turn. So that's what I'm gonna try and do. Plus, next time around, ooh, I can hit the Enforcer with 100% chance. Do it. And then on his next turn, I think he can just drop down on the other side and keep doing what he's been doing. So this Enforcer is toast.
Say my name, she's white. It's Pharaoh.
Alright. And now there's just one Polis bot left, and we're in the clear. This went a lot better than I was envisioning it. Which is awesome, so. Not gonna hear me complaining. Okay, now the two of you pretty much have to get over there, so. I'm gonna let you both sprint. Now. Ducks, can you... Yes, you can get over there and take low cover, plus your way up high. Can you? Do I have? Yeah, I do. All right, do it.
Yeah, I did that. What do you think about that?
It's not as awesome as the state switcher, but at least I get to move and take a shot at him. And now he can reload the state switcher and go right back to doing what he normally does. God, he's amazing when he's up high. So glad I put him up there. As for you two, you don't really have any good shots at this guy, but at least take the shots you have.
Give up now and I'll go easy on ya.
She'll have to reload next turn anyway, so it's not that big a deal. As for Borman, he's got no ammo in his equipped weapon, so he can't... Well, move him out here. Switch weapons, and then shoot at him. We can do the damage, and on my next turn I can switch weapons, reload, and end him. Assuming Dux doesn't finish him off, which seems entirely likely. And we're good! Problem solved. Ugh. Regroup.
Follow me.
Okay, so we're at an hour, but I'm gonna let this one run just a little bit long while I run around and loot everything from all these guys. And we'll also go check out whatever was in the quarantine area. Then I'll probably call it an episode. I might run around in the metal fields a little bit longer just to loot anything that might have been in these buildings that I didn't go into because they were occupied by the metal guys. But I figure we should at least kind of clean up the important parts of this area. Oh, couple of things here. All right.
Look at those ruins in the distance.
There's a smoke
grenade.
Call it
the Forbidden City, right? Creepy place. I never have to go there.
So that's a travel point. Okay, we're not going that way. Well, we actually probably will go that way, just not immediately. Broken gun parts. I'm guessing this is the key. Sure is. Medkit. Is there really nothing, like, super special back here? It was just a medkit that I came back for? That was what the quarantine key had for me? Huh. That's a little bit of a bummer. I mean, medkits are great and all, but I was really kind of expecting... The last time we got a key, it led us into an area that gave us a bunch of extra scrap and a chest. And the only thing that seems to have been in this area was a medkit. Which is nice, but it's valued at about 40 scrap. Nothing really all that crazy or fantastic. I don't see any artifacts. I don't see anything really awesomely worthwhile, but... Alright, at any rate, that's all the time I have for this episode, guys, so thank you all so much for joining me. I really hope you guys are enjoying this series as much as I am. I'm loving this, especially now. After the last episode, I was a little bit frustrated, but I kind of took a step back, realized that I'm doing fine. You know, there were some nasty positions I got myself in, and maybe I made some tactical errors, but I sort of shaped up, learned from those mistakes, and realized that even when I was in trouble... You know, running into some issues that were a little scary and more enemies than I was anticipating and some unfortunate misses, I still came out on top and I used relatively few resources doing it. So, keeping that in mind, I'm in a much better frame of mind and I'm having a lot of fun with this game still. So, anyway, if you're enjoying it, please make sure that you hit that like button. Feel free to leave a comment down in the section below. And as always, guys, I will see everyone in the next episode. Catch you guys later.